Hello everyone, I'm Gökalp KOŞKUN and today I will talk about feminism and misconception of feminism. Especially in this decade, it's a growing problem. Firstly, we will learn what is feminism. Feminism is an idea that fights for equal rights for political, economic and social on men and women. Charles Fourier, a utopian socialist and French philosopher, is credited with having coined the word feminism in 1837. The word feminism and feminist first appeared in France and Netherlands in 1872. Great Britain in the 1890s and the United States in 1710. Oxford English Dictionary lists 1852 as the year of the first appearance of feminists and 1854 feminism. Depending on the historical moment, culture and country, feminists around the world have had different causes and goals. Most Western feminist historians contend that all movements working to obtain women's rights should be considered feminist movements even when they didn't or don't apply the term to themselves. Other historians assert that the term should be limited to the modern feminist movements and its descendants. Those historians use the label proto-feminist to describe earlier movements. The history of the modern Western feminist movements is divided into three waves. Each wave deals with different aspects of the same feminist issues. The first wave comprised women's suffrage movements of the 19th and 20th centuries, promoting women's right to vote. The second wave was associated with the ideas and actions of the women's liberation movement beginning in the 1960s. The second wave campaigned for legal and social equality for women. The third wave is a continuation of and a reaction to perceived failures of second wave feminists. Fourth wave feminism refers to resurgence of interest in feminism that began around 2012 and is associated with the use of social media. According to feminist scholar Prudence Chamberlain, the focus of the fourth wave is justice for women and opposition to sexual harassment and violence against women. Its essence, she writes, is increasingly that certain attitudes can still exist. Fourth wave feminism is defined by technology, according to Kira Cochrane, and is characterized particularly by the use of Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Tumblr and blogs such as feminism to challenge misogyny and further gender equality. We have learned feminism, so we can talk about our real problem, misconception of feminism. In these days, this problem is getting out of hand. It's not a new problem. But in the past, there was less feminazis. Yes, this is a new concept. But in the past, this word used to explain extreme and radical feminists. They don't want to have equal rights. They want to humiliate men. They are heart of our problems. They are sparking other feminists to fight for making problems. They are creating positive discrimination against men. For example, in these days, violence against men is not getting attention as much as women's. Don't get it wrong, I'm not promoting violence. It's just an extreme example. I'm trying to say feminists are making mistakes while trying to have equal rights. They are insulting men's rights. While trying to have feminism is not to have toward men. The point of feminism is not to discriminate against men. Feminism is not a movement to discourage men. Feminism is not a movement plotting to pull all men out of power. Feminism is not a movement to promote women's superiority. Feminism is for everyone. Feminism are for men and women. I think all the talk was about problems and concepts. Now I will talk about my solutions. Firstly, we have two concepts, matriarchy and patriarchy. Both of them defend men are or women are superior. Most of people have patriarchy and feminists trying to destroy it. But if they success, matriarchy will come. Absolutely not in 2 or 3 years. It will take generations. So that is not the solution. If we will destroy something, it should be both of them. We should talk like they are equal to or our child, because they are equal. What is the difference? One of them born as man, other didn't. Is that makes man leader or makes man woman worthless? I can answer this for you. Both of them doesn't matter, because it's not important for me or real feminists. If you try to grow and deploy that idea, we will be able to build a new equal generation. Equal about rights, economic or political. They will not judge each other for their gender. So that's all my ideas about the subject. Try to be a real feminist. Thanks.